everybody. We're back.
Thank you, and welcome back. If you have not tuned in yet, we just blew up docs in a spectacular fashion in this particular part of the campaign. So please tune in. We're going to get back into the action of playing the game soon. But first, you know, as a new player, I have never played a role-playing game before. This is actually my very first time playing a role-playing
Woo!
Game. So
One of us.
It's been a blast so far, if you'll excuse the pun. How good is this particular game at getting new people involved and being able to play? You know, is this a good place to start,
Savage Worlds is a fantastic game for new players. I mean, Kitty, you've never played Savage Worlds before, and you seem to be having a really good time with it so
far.
Yeah,
I like the variety
You've picked up the basics, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know? So you look at your attributes and you know what to roll. You look at your skills and you know what to roll. You're more than halfway there, just understanding that. And then the rest of it just layers very, very easily on top of that. Like an edge, you only have like five or six edges for a character, but each of the edges, like you just, oh, I know what that does. It gives me a bonus here, or it helps me with that. So it layers very, very nicely. And Savage Worlds as a game system, you know, of course Savage Worlds is a game system, right? You start at 0 point novice, and you're not zero from hero. Your 0 point novice character is still pretty awesome. They're pretty badass, right? You can make a 0 point character, and you're still able to be, maybe you're not Dr. Jones at the height of his career, but you know, young Indiana, and you're still kicking some butt. The cool thing about that is like every five experience points, you get to add a thing, like a new edge or a couple of skills. So you can very gradually and organically improve your character over time. So by the time you've got a bunch of experience, you already really understand what you're doing and be able to really be on top of the character. Now, as I've said time and time again, Savage Rifts, Rifts for Savage Worlds, is Savage Worlds cranked to 11? So a lot of you playing 0 point characters, but you're playing 0 point characters with a lot of power layered on top of them. And that was the only way to really do justice to the way Rifts presented these very super powerful concepts. So Twitch is this crazy who can lose it and has just got all kinds of I can ignore damage and ignore fear and I'm super fast and you know it's hard to hit me and all these other things. And it wouldn't be a crazy if he didn't have those on his sheets to start with. So we used a similar idea to what they did with the Superpowers Companion, and prior to that what's called Necessary Evil, which is a setting, which is superpower orientation, which is you still build a basic character, but then you can layer on top a whole bunch of superpowers that go with that character, like the super flight or strength or whatever. So we took a similar approach to that, but we did a little bit more structured, like these iconic frameworks. You know, just take this framework of cool abilities all linked together, go boom, Leyline Walker, boom, you know, Mind Melter. Although again, we also still, in keeping with the spirit of Savage Worlds, we also managed to...
Don't worry about that.
We also managed to keep a lot of flexibility, right? So we gave some frameworks for doing things like operators and rogue scholars and vagabonds, and these classic ideas that were in Rifts. We just sort of said, okay, if you wanted to build one of those guys, here's how you do it. But you get a lot more flexibility. You get all these extra level ups and skill points and all these other things. And as we've seen with Ross's character in this game, Cactus Jacqueline, she is built on the framework of what's called Mars, which is that group I was just talking about, where you get the more experience points and the more other stuff. But Ross went in and custom built this character. So we have seen a power armor jock with missile launchers and all that. But she also has extraordinary psionic abilities that she can use on top of that. So it's a really interesting mix. So Rifts had these fairly very, very powerful concepts that you just grab that concept and you go. But Savage Worlds also encourages creativity and flexible game creation, and we were able to import that as well into this. So for brand new players, Savage Rifts is going to be a little bit more, but every time I've run a demo, I've had a new player, or more than one new player, and they've been fine with it. So I think it does work just fine.
Fantastic.
You've had a good time, right?
Oh yeah, this is a blast. I am.
You've never role played before.
I've never role played before. This is so much fun, and I don't feel lost. I don't feel like everybody is just talking way above my level about what's going on. And I think that anybody that wanted to get into a role playing game would really enjoy this system very much. G2V Scott says he is a Savage Worlds evangelist, and none is as easy to explain to a new player as Savage Worlds is. Apparently there is some agreement with that statement. Now, when we first started the chat and we started playing the game, Some people were saying that they never played with a map before, that they just kind of played without that element to the game. Do you find that the map makes it a little bit more fulfilling, or that it adds, or does it allow you to do more as a GM, and does it allow players to do more?
So I'm famous for this argument, actually. I have arguments online. Ron Blessing and I have been back and forth on this. He's a well-known blogger and vlogger, and I've been on a number of podcasts and video talk show things about the use of miniatures versus, and I'll go and say this. Savage Worlds was originally developed as a skirmish miniatures and role-playing game system, so it is designed primarily around the idea of using miniatures or tokens and having a map and things like that. Having said that, I know plenty of players who run Savage Worlds without minis, without maps, and they do just fine with your theater of the mind. It really comes down to style. Both styles are perfectly valid. Both styles work just fine. I've seen Shane Hensley himself run theater of the mind, no problem at all. I love toys, obviously, and I bought the thing we're using for the robot armor I got from a Cracker Barrel because it just looks so cool. I mean, I love using toys. For me, it helps me keep track. It's my style of jamming. I love having my toys on the table, and I know where they are, and I love using the movement and all that kind of stuff. And yes, the game absolutely supports that. The game is absolutely set up for that. But again, scratch sheet of paper, just have a basic idea everybody is. There's a stat called pace. And pace, hey Catherine, how's it going?
Hey,
one of my Monday Night Savages just popped in to say hi. Pace is a stat that if you're not using maps and miniatures, it has a little less meaning. But as long as everybody's okay with that, then you can just kind of go, well, he's got a higher pace, so he's going to get there first, and just do it that way. So either way's fine. Either way works just fine.
Okay, so I mean, just speaking as somebody who doesn't have all these resources necessarily available to them, if a group of people that wanted to get into role playing, they could go to your Kickstarter, they could back it, they could get the necessary elements that they needed, and they wouldn't need the figures and the maps and everything like that. It just kind of enhances that experience in your mind.
Absolutely not. I mean, we played a game at ChupaCabraCon this past weekend. Really great convention down in Austin, Texas, by the way. Cheap plug for my friends. Great con. You should go. And Ed Wetterman, who's part of the guys who did ETU, East Texas University, which is sort of a Buffy the Vampire-esque kind of modern-day horror thing, did Chickens in the Mist, which is like a comedy horror game, and everything was Lego miniatures, like minifigs and giant Lego chickens. So anything can be used, and used with a lot of fun for that. But do not let the fact that I'm using all these toys intimidate you. That's just me. I spend all my money on toys. It's kind of a problem I have, and I need a 12-step program. But having said that, absolutely. And in fact, I mean, there's characters. I mean, Cactus Jacqueline got ranges on her weapons that are 50, 100, 200 game inches. So the ranges is almost pointless on the map. But you can just do that on a piece of paper and through theater of mind. It will work just fine.
So Food Paste in the chat asks, why is Savage Worlds at a 1/72nd scale rather than D&D's 1/60th scale? Is there a particular
Wow. Oh my god, I have no idea. That was just what
Food Paste, you have your answer. We have zero idea
Clint
why.
Clint Black can answer that.
check with Clint Black. He's our rules aficionado. Shane designed it that way.
Is that Peg underscore Clint on the chat?
Yes, Peg underscore Clint on the chat. So yeah, Clint, I'm going to throw that one to you, brother. I think it's just a matter of 2 meters, one square equals 2 meters or 2 yards. It's just kind of the way we go with it, and it just works.
He said he could get an answer for that. So, we'll let Clint take that one, and Food Peace seems happy by that.
All right.
And again, we are joined by live chat. I'm checking that chat stream, so anybody that has any questions, it appears that we have some rules aficionados inside the chat. They're answering questions. I see that that's being moderated. But if you have any questions about what we're doing, or are interested in asking the creators and developers some questions about this, then please go ahead, ask them in the chat there. I will happily ask those questions even in game, and I'm sure Sean would be happy to answer those questions for anybody.
When the game is over, we'll try to cover a bunch of questions as well. Kitty wanted to ask us something.
Kitty has a question.
Yes, so do you have as part of the kit when you buy the game for the first time, are there any prepared characters that you can jump start with?
I'm really glad you asked that. I'm going to take it over here. It's like, hi, folks. So we want to talk about the Kickstarter real quick. I'm given to understand that with as many people who are coming to the chat, a lot of you are coming to the Savage Revs Kickstarter for the first time. You've only got 2 hours, 12 minutes, and 16 seconds to get in on this. It is a huge Kickstarter. It is pretty exciting, and that's what this is all about. So You are able to get any number of pledge levels, and I don't have them on the top of my head, but they're right there clearly on the thing. So there's a player's guide, which is everything you need to build characters and play the basic game using the Savage Worlds rules. You would still need the core Savage Worlds rule set as well, which is something you can get as an add-on. And that's just a $10 add-on. Actually, yeah, this right here. So this is the core rules. This little book will let you play anything right there. You know, pulp, sci-fi, western, fantasy, all of it. You know, the core rules right there will set you up. The Savage Rift stuff just really, really expands out on this. The player's guide is the first thing that comes with that. There's also a game master's guide, which is everything you need to know about understanding the world of Rifts from a GM perspective and running Savage Rifts, including rules for dealing with random adventures, random Rift events, and things like that. There's also the Savage Foes of North America, which is basically a bestiary. It's a monsters and bad guys book. With a number of adventures also included in that. There's a fourth project. Ross also helped me write the GM's guide. Ross wrote the first key adventure for it.
Garnet Town Gambit.
Garnet Town Gambit. That is the GM screen adventure, and depending on what package you get the GM screen, which has all kinds of useful stuff and great art, and it comes with the Garnet Town Gambit, which is a really good adventure that mixes high action with some really important and meaningful character player choices, and it really brings to home the conflict and how not black and white it can be sometimes when you're dealing with the Coalition and the Federation. Then there's three other adventures.
There's Murderthon.
Yep, which is another adventure that Ross wrote.
Right, there's Tome of Vengeance, which is the second one, and then there's Daryl Hayhurst, who wrote, what is the name of his adventure? I can't remember it. Let me bring up the page. He wrote this awesome adventure that has a bunch of Zeta 6 in it. It's fantastic.
Sorry about that, Daryl. We're a little brain dead right now. So there's a bunch of adventures.
And 12 one-sheets.
Yes, we released 12 one-sheets out of this thing.
So far.
Archetypes. Yes, we have a folio of, where it's going to end up being 12 archetypes, which are pre-generated characters. You can just grab and go right off the bat. And you're going to have come with really,
The Contamination Principle is Daryl's game.
The Contamination Principle is Daryl's one. And then there's 12 archetypes. We unlocked all of those. And they're both male and female characters of all these
human
different
types.
Human and DB. I'm sorry?
Are they human and
DB? Yes. I go back and rewrite some of them to make them DB since we unlocked the DBs for the player's guide. So so that's all going on. And so archetypes, and then there's cool specialized dice. There's bennies you can get. There's a really cool bag, a gamer's bag you can get. There's this pretty cool slip case that you can put all your books in. So there's all these really neat things. So folks, if you're really interested in this, you're never going to get a better deal on all this stuff unless you get it on the Kickstarter. And as I said, we're down to 2 hours and 9 minutes and some seconds. This thing is huge. It's one of the biggest things I've ever been involved in. We're extremely proud. Thank you all for your kind support. This is the famous Rift setting officially brought forward from 1990 into 2016 with a new rule set and a new way to play, and everyone's been having a lot of fun with this. So thank you all for joining us.
Yes, and we want to say thank you to all the backers who've helped us so far, and anybody who wants to look at the Kickstarter and think about supporting us, we would really appreciate it as we go into the final hours.
Right. And when we get done with this game, we're going to hang out for a little bit and chat. We'll be answering questions. We're going to be partying a little bit because, man, this has been one heck of a ride. I'm still looking at the screen and not the camera. I'm sorry. I'm used to web chatting, which the camera's right on top of the screen, and the screen's over there, and you guys are there, so I apologize. All right, so anything
Except
else?
Radio, yeah, actually, before we transfer back to the game, as a brand new player, if I was going to be backing your Kickstarter, which level would I want to be on to make sure I get the materials I need to, run a game, introduce some people into the game?
And that's the question, is whether you want to actually be a game master for this or not. If you want to be a player, then just grab the player's guide.
Which is $15.
Which is $15. It's a real easy buy there. If you want to be a game master, if you want to grab the PDFs, I think it's $45 for all the PDFs. If you want to get into the physical books, though, then
$55 for the ultimate player, which is all the player stuff in physical. And then the GM is going to be, depending on what you want, between $85 and $150.
And what's been blowing our minds away is how many game masters are coming in for top dollar. One of the reasons why this thing has gotten so high is because with all the cool stuff, all these GMs are going in. But you got to realize this is a game setting people have been wanting to get back into for 25, 26 years.
And there's a great question right now about what the difference is between buying in now and later. Well, the thing is, you're getting the player's guide, which is expanded from 96 pages to, I think
probably
it's like
150.
Yeah, you're getting an expanded player's guide for the same price today that you would. It'll be higher after the Kickstarter. So you're absolutely getting a deal if you Kickstarter, if you help us now as opposed to later on the Player's Guide.
Exactly right. The best deal, Player's Guide. We did not up the cost on the Player's Guide, so fantastic deal on that. If you wait until after, you will be paying the full price for that. It is going to be a bigger book and therefore a more expensive book. I can't tell you exactly how much it's going to end up being, but the price point will be higher. So now is a perfect time to get it for that. And there's a lot of exclusives on this Kickstarter that will not be available outside, like the special bag and the dice and all those really cool things. Those are all the Kickstarter exclusives. So there's that.
So we want to get back into the game action. A few of you have asked some questions, and we've also gotten some direct messages. We're going to be addressing all of those in the interview portion, which is actually going to happen after we finish this campaign up, or this particular part of it. So please join us back for then. Your questions will be answered. We also have a couple people, again, developers and rules aficionados in the game, that are answering those questions inside the chat. So I'm sure Clint and others will be answering those questions as well. So without further ado, let's go back to Sean.
All right.
And we'll get back into the game.
Okay, folks. So when we last left our heroes, they had diabolically, foibled my plans to have them go through the rave going on upstairs. And they're using, once again, the sewers to tunnel their way into where the necromancer is doing all his horrible stuff.
Well, there's people in danger of being sacrificed, and I think we need to go do something about that.
Well, there's that.
That's why we're here.
All right.
Heroes.
So we're going to... I took a stab at giving you guys sort of a marching order if you guys want to rearrange yourselves somehow.
I'm fine with where I am.
I'm good.
So, Kitty, are you good with where she is?
I'm good.
All right. And...
Mentok, are you cool being in the middle?
Absolutely. I love it in the middle.
All right.
Family phrasing. Are we not doing phrasing anymore? All right. So as you guys are making your way there, I'm just going to go around the table again to see if there's anybody doing anything special in preparation or anything like that. Spellcasters, of course, now would be a time of whether or not you want to go ahead and get any of your powers going or not.
Sixth Sense.
I'm sorry?
How'd the boat get in?
Well, that's not the boat. I'm using that to block. There's a section of the map that I don't want to use. So I'm using that to block that. That section does not exist. So I'm just using that to cover that.
Only thing I've got going on that you need to be aware of is Sixth Sense.
All right, so you've got your Sixth Sense going, of course.
I have Detect Arcana at will.
Okay.
So I can do that as well.
Well, you still would need to let me know when you're, like, reaching out and sensing yourself.
Oh. Anyway. I'm maintaining my greater armor.
All right, so you're maintaining that.
And I have the Detect Arcana. It will.
So you're at this point, assuming as you guys are walking along, you're sensing. I'm going to tell you right now, you're both sensing dark magics down here. This whole place is just steeped in necromancy.
And I told you about all the undead I saw, zombies and skeletons and murder wraiths.
Oh my.
Right. Exactly.
And is it pitch dark everywhere down there?
In the sewer, it would be, except Cactus Jacqueline's got the giant floodlights going.
So
like
I don't
that.
Need to.
So we're not likely to be eaten by a grue.
No, you're not. You will not be eaten by a grue. So what an old school reference that was.
nor will we die of dysentery.
All right,
we got to see all the disgusting stuff. As opposed to
you're not on the Oregon Trail, and you're not being eaten by a grue. All right. Arturo, anything in preparation?
Nope. I'm just going to have my Psy sword available, laser pistol in the other hand, and I'm going to take the lead.
Am I just holding you?
All right. Well, right now I've got you online with Twitch and with Marcus. Do you guys want to let him go a little bit ahead or not? First off, is Arturo known to be stealthy?
He is not known to be stealthy.
All right, then.
He's known to put a boot to the door occasionally.
Right. Is Twitch known to be stealthy?
I would tell that by...
You'd have a skill name...
Yes, yes.
That's also a personal choice thing, too.
So, is Twitch known to bother being stealthy, whether he can or not?
Yes, grenades help with that.
Right now we can be stealthy. Right now we're in a good place.
Might want to remind them how this works.
Oh, yeah. So, by the way, everybody, remember your turquoise chip is your nomination chip for good roleplay and stuff like that. So, or to save somebody's, dumbass because things are not going well for them.
You can't take it with you.
Oh, by the way, you guys all did really well that last one, so I am going to hand out one bonus penny to everybody on this one. There we go. All right.
Well, if Sir Arturo's not going to say it, I am. This whole situation here stinks, and the people of Wycliffe deserve better than this. Let's get in there and kick some undead butt.
All right, time to lose it. Let's go.
So you're like, Losing it?
Let's lose it.
So Twitch is going on, all of a sudden you're like, well, I said Twitch is getting really, really twitchy.
I let go of his leash.
And Marcus, what do you think you're doing in preparation?
No.
All right. So you guys are making your way along here.
Hey, you quit your twitching.
Oh, wait, I need to deflect first, then lose it.
Okay. Yeah, he's going to turn on deflection.
You cannot activate any psionics while you're... So you guys are...
So deflect first, then lose it.
So if you guys pretty much just staying together as a group coming up here?
Yep.
All right. Well, in that case, there is no attempt at stealthing, I assume.
Yeah, because I do not want to be in front of any gun.
I mean, they never expect a frontal attack from the basement.
Yeah, they're all looking this way. Yeah.
I don't need stealth. Right about the time that you get there, these doors open up. And a couple of skeletons are standing there. So, I mean, again, these things, they are just classic Ray Harryhausen, if you will, skeletons, except these skeletons would have weapons, if I could remember what I did with the sheet. Hang on.
I hope y'all have some ear protection, because it's about to get loud down here.
All right.
Those of you with extra good hearing.
I just want to remark that Twitch is getting twitchy on Twitch. That's a pretty interesting...
Wow.
I need you to never speak again.
Okay, that's fine.
All right. Move your thing there. I'm actually going to have to spread out a little bit here.
I would like to remark at this time that I have a -2 to charisma. So I think
but your character.
That one played flat.
Can I give him my chip for that?
You actually want to reward him for that? Because that was awful. All right, so these, by the way, these skeletons actually are carrying, they're skeletons, like standard necromantic skeletons, carrying C10 light assault laser rifles. So there's that. So they open the door up and they look somewhat surprised. I mean, they heard something. So they throw the door open, and really that just says cards to me right there as you guys are all laid down. They want to shoot you. We'll see if they get a chance. All right, we'll start with Marcus.
We do have one quick question.
Yes.
Chaotic asks, I forget, what is the power armor? So what is that large power armor?
That's a sweet.
All right, the power armor's... Ross named it Widowmaker, but it is a specific type.
Its model is a Ultimax, a Triax Ultimax.
Okay.
Yeah. So Cactus Jacqueline is piloting an Ultimax. Marcus Wan, 7 of Diamonds. Cactus Jacqueline, 7 of Spades.
Woo!
Twitch does not take that because you were already very, very twitchy.
I'm ready to go.
So Joker, our first one. So Twitch ends up with a Joker.
Joker's wild.
The Joker is wild. And then Arturo gets the Joker.
Yes!
So here come these Jokers.
These zombies are
Six
screwed.
Of clubs for Raspberry Wine. And Ace of Diamonds for you.
That's each square, right?
Yeah, that's each square.
So the skeletons start with... Oh, look at that.
Oh my god.
So they get a Joker of Hearts. And yes, because this is a 4 Joker deck, which is a personal custom deck, I did suit the Joker. So that means Arturo will go first. The skeletons, if they're still alive, unlikely second. Twitch next, and then we'll go on from there. All right, so that will kill that deck, because nobody else is even going to have a draw this time. All right, so we start with Arturo on Joker of Spades. Oh, wait, before anything else, yes, you guys all get a Benny for that.
Yay!
Yes.
This is a setting rule called the Joker's Wild.
And this is a core Savage World setting rule.
Because the Joker is supposed to represent something awesome happening.
Right.
And because it's rare.
So each person that drew the Joker, you get +2 on all your rolls, +2 on any damage you do. And, so there's that. All right, Arturo.
I do apologize to the other Jokers in the room. so I'm going to go over our cyborg.
Yeah, basically parkour above him. And
yep, I've got a pace of 8, so...
that was 4.
Yep, so, and now I'm just going to multi-action laser pistol sword.
All right, so as you're charging forward, you're going to laser pistol one of them, and then you're going to use the sword on the other.
Sword on the other. Yeah.
All right.
So let's go ahead and laser pistol the one on my left. I got a 4.
A 4 will hit.
Okay. So that is 2d6 damage.
And you get +2 because of the Joker.
Yep.
And champion.
Oh, yes, you are a champion. These are unnatural evil.
Yep, so that would be a grand total of 10.
10 points of damage. Is that with all? That's basically the +4?
Yep, with the +4.
That's still not quite enough to take him out, but that will shake him. And then hitting with the other one, the sword?
Yep.
All right, bring it.
That's a 9 to hit.
9, they count, no, they do not count as unarmed defenders.
11, actually, because of champion. Then, no, that's
champions for damage.
So you did not hear the raise.
What about the plus 2 for Joker?
Plus 2 for Joker?
Then
11. That's 11.
You will hear the raise.
Excellent.
Roll that beautiful damage.
Okay.
Now, so this is the first time you guys have gotten to see the Cyber Knight's sword. Cyber Knight, the Cyber Knight's side blade does not have a base damage. It is all based on the Cyber Knight stats. So Cyber Knight's spirit die twice and his strength die once is the base damage of the sword.
He's hitting he's hitting you with his soul.
Yep.
So that is going to be a grand total of 2d8 plus 2D6. With the raise 2d6.
Now the worst part is when he starts boosting his spirit and or his strength, because that gets really gross. Or somebody else does. I actually had somebody boost his spirit to like a d12 plus 2 at 120. It was crazy.
Yeah, that's not as cool as I wanted it to be, but
now, 10, there's a setting rule called Blood and Guts.
Yeah, plus 2 to damage.
And with the Blood and Guts rule, Lee, you can spend a Benny to reroll damage.
So it's like having the...
But hold on, before you do,
mm-hmm.
Let's get your total, because remember you're plus 4.
Yeah, so that's 10. 12, 13.
Dead.
Okay.
Dave, toughness is 7. That was more than enough. You took him out.
So all right.
That is one smited skeleton.
He has been smoked.
Now, that was 4, and that one's shaking. You can move on in if you want.
Yeah, I will.
5, 6.
I'm going to 7. And I'm going to look down the corner.
So, yeah, you look around the corner, and you actually do. There is light down there. It's a cold, spooky light.
Okay.
And there are actually guttering torches and lamps and phosphorescent lights. Some of them, most of them don't work, but some do. So it is dim in most of these hallways. Dim basically is a -1 penalty for lighting penalties, which won't matter. Actually, through here, it doesn't matter because your freaking floodlights, whoosh. But otherwise, it would be dim. In there, it's perfectly fine lighting. So you look down in there,
yep.
And you see the zombies. You think you see a murder wraith back there. You hear something. What? Damn it! And then some scuffling and moving. So you've got one more movement left, or you're going to hold where you are?
Yeah,
move
me up into the cell. The nearest cell.
Move you in. Well, that's the furthest you
can go. There's people in there.
Oh, that's, so. Oh, I can go one more?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll go there and just...
All right, so you're there. Crouch. That is you on Joker of Spades. Turn the card in, please. Joker of Hearts, which is the skeletons, which are dead. So much for that.
One's shaken.
Whoa, hey, thank you very much. One is shaken. So first off, it gets to make a spirit check to unshake.
You should pass it with the Joker bonus.
And it totally does.
Yeah, you couldn't fail.
So, yeah, one would have been the only way to fail. You're not supposed to go there, so... It will move to there to shoot you because it's supposed to be guarding that room, and you are the thing it should be guarding against. So it's going to shoot you. Skeletons, you know, they're dime a dozen. What the? Yeah. So it's spinning around, moving, and you're like almost casually backhand deflect the bolt with your sword. So they're done, and we go to Twitch.
All right. Well, let's turn on deflection.
All right. And do you want to do any other actions this round?
Yeah, I'm going to sprint around the corner as far as I can.
Okay, and do you intend to attack anything?
I'm going to lob grenades into here.
All right, so we are activating a power, which is an action, assuming you just use your base pace, which is really high, we won't worry about
12.
Running, and then you're going to throw. So those are two actions.
And I'm
minus
allowed,
2.
That's not counted as a miss, so I don't have
minus two for multiple action ability, but plus 2 for the Joker, so you're even up on any rolls here. So first thing you want to do is roll your psionic skill and spend your ISB to activate your deflection. Yeah, this is one of the big things. I mean, there was always a difference between crazies and juicers thematically. Juicers have got some really cool abilities. Crazies aren't quite as juicy, so to speak, but they are really—they're still pretty badass, and they have psionics. So that's a pretty effective thing. So what'd you get?
5.
All right. So unless you want to spend a Benny to extra effort, which -4 deflection do not suck. But it's up to you whether you want to spend it or not. Right now, you're at -2 deflection for your psionics and -2 for uncanny reflexes. So
Twitch, please.
Yeah, may as well.
But he's got the Joker that did the +2, right?
Right, but that also is -2 penalty for multiple action.
Right.
So,
did one more time.
Well, hold on, stop. Did you do... rewind. What I said is you might want to spend for extra effort, which would have been adding a D6 to your original 5.
Adding a D6.
All right.
So, did you want an extra effort or reroll? Extra effort
means... No, the extra effort's fine.
So roll a single D6. Does he have a line?
No.
No.
Okay. So you ended with 5, plus 2 is a 7. Unfortunately, you didn't quite get there. You needed the 3 or better. So the odds were in your favor, but didn't quite get it. So unfortunately, also, because you extra effort, you may not re-roll, so that's it. Okay. So you didn't quite get it, but okay. Still, you're minus 4 to your head, so doesn't suck. So at this point, you said you just want to run around and throw a grenade?
Yes.
And your movement is what?
12.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, cut through him, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
The skeleton and can't do anything about it?
Huh?
The skeleton's not armed or
anything. Oh, actually the skeleton will take a swiping blow. That is correct. Thank you, Ross.
He's going to try and twitch slap you.
So he will completely miss. There's no chance in hell he's going to miss. All right. So yeah, he's got the gun. He lets go with this hand and tries to claw you with the skeletal claws. But yeah, even with a 6... You're minus 4, 2 is not going to hit your parry. So you get to there, and I said you said you wanted to toss a grenade.
Yes.
So that would be a throwing roll.
Yep. Where do you want to throw the grenade, and what kind of grenade are you throwing?
Well, that's what I was going to ask. I've got AP grenades, frag grenades, or...
Plasma grenades.
HE.
Or high explosive grenades.
Yeah, and plasma. So which one's going to do if I try to slob something in between people, which one's going to do the most?
Well, that's up to you, man.
I don't know which one does. I don't know what kind of damage.
Well, they should say on there. There'll be dice of damage.
Small burst template.
Oh, large
burst.
That's
a medium burst template. Small.
The plasma is the big boy.
Yep. Plasma's a small burst template.
And that's small, medium, and large right there.
Right, so the plasma one's for good for trying to crack open a heavy armored opponent.
Right.
You know, then that's your medium burst, and then that's your large burst.
Frag grenades, large burst.
Okay, and where did you want to lob it? Because where it lands matters.
We're going to try to...
Try it right there.
Right, yeah, try
to... All right.
That's close to the innocence, just so you
know. Yeah, we could probably get this one.
Yeah, is there any innocence in there?
Yeah, you guys did know there were innocence over here.
Right. Yeah, so if we center it, like, right about there.
Okay. And by the way, he is currently Schrodinger's... Necromancer, because you don't know if he's there or not.
Okay.
Make a throwing roll.
You can see the others, you don't see him, and you don't know where he is.
But you are getting the murder wraith in the blast, and that's important.
The orange and the green.
Yeah.
All right, so you have a joker, which is plus 2, multiple action, minus 2, so it's a straight up roll.
6, 10, 9.
So
10,
9.
11, or no, sorry. 9, yeah.
Nine will hit the race.
No, and, well, yeah, I have plus 2. Does this count as fighting?
No, this is throwing. All right. So it goes off where you want it to. By the way, Schrodinger's necromancer was actually over here at the time. Because he went over to do something important. I'm not cheating. That's he actually fine. Really went over there. As you guys couldn't see him, and I was just. All right. So anyway. But
hey, payback is a twitch.
You wanted me to leave?
All your bennies are belong to me. So you got a raise. So roll the damage.
Oh, I get a nom out of that.
What? That's so
raspberry wine. I can really appreciate that.
That's wrong. All right, so roll damage. You do get a raise.
No, you don't give me one. He gives me one.
Oh, sorry, I threw it the wrong way. I was supposed to. Yes, I get a raise. I threw it to her. I threw it to you. I got you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So did you say I had a raise?
You yes. rolled a
so you get extra d6 of damage.
Okay.
Yep. So
rolled up.
Nice.
Come on.
Ooh. 20 so far.
All right. So the zombies are gone. They're just gone.
25 with the plus.
25 with the Joker. Yeah.
25 with the Joker. The murder wraith would take a wound, but can't. But that will still shake him. Boom! All right. And turn your card in, please, sir.
I like the Joker.
Well, you used the Joker, and it is now...
It was super effective.
It was. Twitch uses the Joker and a grenade. It was super effective. And Mentok, you are up, sir, with an ace of diamonds. You currently have no powers going.
Okay. Just so I understand exactly kind of what's happening in this board, do we know that everything is here, or is this just set up for the purpose
you,
of...
You were given a rough idea of where things were believed to be when she first did. Again? You don't know if they've moved since then.
Okay.
I wouldn't.
So I turn to Marcus, and I say, will you come with me and protect me?
Of course.
All right, fantastic. I am
very
going
heroic of you, Mentok.
I am going to head this way.
Okay. So your pace is 6, I believe.
Yes.
All right, so you...
And remember, as you pass him, he'll get to attack you, so you have to decide whether you want to stop and attack him.
All right, so you get there for free. To move any further, you would have to do what's called a run action. That would be one of your actions for the round. And you would roll a d6 for run. I don't know if you have any flight or any other movement abilities or something like that.
I don't have any other movement abilities, as far as I can tell.
Do you have telekinesis?
Nope.
No?
Maybe not. Maybe I do.
No, you don't, actually. All right, never mind. Then don't worry about it. So you can move 6. That is as far as you can move as a free action. If you want to move any further, you roll a d6 and you run that, and it counts as one of your actions for the round.
May I attempt to mind control that guy there that I think is there? Or can I not see him yet?
The only person who can see him. Nobody can see him, actually.
Right. So you would... You can't... It's normally a lot of sight.
Mm-hmm.
You would have to do telepathy on him first.
Okay.
Which you could... You could, or it's just a skeleton, he doesn't want to remind.
No brain.
What you could do, however, is hold.
Okay.
You could hold until he becomes visible and then try to interrupt him, and then try to take control of his mind before he does anything else. That is an option.
Otherwise, let you interrupt.
I do want to do that. Yeah, that sounds really good.
The other option is to move there and do multiple actions. The first action is to try to reach him with telepathy,
mm-hmm.
and once you sense him with telepathy, then as a second, action for that round, try to mind control. So you can do that.
What
now.
Would a mind melter do in this situation?
What would a magnificent?
Oh yes, I will do telepathy now.
We are going balls to the wall. You also are a major psionic, which means you can spend additional energy to get bonuses to offset your penalties.
Right. Okay.
So, you are -2 because you're doing two different actions.
Joke. Okay.
Oh, and you got... No, he didn't get the joke. He was ace of diamonds. So, you're -2 for these actions unless you want to spend any ISP. You won't spend any bennies yet. You spend those after.
For the rolls, right. I do want to spend extra ISP for this telepathy.
Okay. Go for it.
So, I get... I can spend 2 ISP for +1 on my psionics.
Yeah.
Right?
Every 2 is +1.
Okay, I'm going to spend 2 on this.
Should you give your +1?
Or team, should I do more? Or should I spend it on...
You should spend it on the mind control.
Yep. Spend it on the mind control.
Cool.
Yeah, you're going to need it on the mind control.
All right, so telepathy plus my boost is 4, so I'm down to 19. All right. Psionics. D10.
Getting control of a murder wraith in this situation could be really freaking effective.
I sure hope so.
Yeah, but you're looking for the necromancer, though.
So it's a 5, which is over my natural roll, but
right.
It's
so it's 5 minus 1 because you offset by 1, so mm-hmm. It's 4.
Okay.
All right. So, or did you spend it?
I spent extra.
Okay, so you got the plus 1. So minus 1 is 4, which is still going to be a success. All right. You've sensed him well enough that you can now attempt a mind control.
Oh yeah, we're definitely doing that. That's
take his mind.
And I'm gonna boost that with 4 ISP for a +2.
There you go. That will offset your penalties completely. And this becomes an opposed roll against his spirit. So he has a spirit of D8. Man, not real good.
This is the time. It's an 8.
8. Well, now are you doing? You're doing mind control, like full on.
Full on mega power mind control, baby.
Spend for extra effort. You want the raise?
Oh, do I?
No, actually.
Oh, he's good. Okay, never mind.
Yeah, all this does is.
Oh, it's mind control, not puppet. Never mind.
He's doing mind control, which gives him a very extended duration. So
right, sorry.
If he got the raise, it would be a minute versus having control of him for 5 minutes. But this battle's not going to last a minute.
You're right. Never mind. I was confused. I was thinking puppet.
It was not a bad instinct, but in this case, you've probably got it for long enough. So, and if nothing else, you can just read it later. So, guess what? You have reached out and find him and snatched him.
Taking his mind.
Boom. Mind taking.
And over the telepathic thing, yes, master. So yeah, you got him. That's your thing.
Can I take an action as him, as the murder wraith now?
Yes.
Is it the necromancer or the murder wraith?
This is the murder wraith he just took control. Okay.
So, yes.
All right. What do you want to do with him?
Go kill the other murderer.
You need to give general instructions, and then I'll handle it, because you don't know everything he absolutely can do.
Absolutely. I tell him.
Kill undead. Yeah. Kill the undead.
I tell him to go find the other petroleum murder wraith and kill him.
Okay.
That's my instruction. Go find the other
murder wraiths. Have a pace of 16. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So he comes running around the corner.
Yes.
He doesn't bother shooting. He doesn't bother shooting the rifle because that's not going to do anything. And he knows it.
Bob, what's up?
So
here I am, just minding my own business.
He drops the gun and is just jumping him to basically attack him with, you know, he's going to try to eat him.
So yes.
That's the one thing he knows that would actually kill another murder wraith. All right, I'm going to let you roll for the attack. The other murder wraith's like, what the hell? So roll a fighting check of D12. He's not a wild card, so just roll a...
Just the D12.
One.
10.
All right, 10 minus 2 is an 8, is still a hit.
Rawr.
Nom, 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 nom.
So roll a D12.
Against what is tough?
And
because now he hit, now he's rolling damage.
Roll a D12 plus a D4.
And then this goes against the guy's tough. Because he beat the guy's parry. All
right, parry that is garbage. Since he is under your control, I will let you spend a Benny to reroll his damage.
Boom.
Normally that's kind of an situation, but it's too cool. I'm gonna let you. Oh dear God! I'm gonna regret that I did. So that 12 rolls up.
Yep.
That is an ace. So that 12 rolls up.
Ooh.
So we are at 13. Then what's that?
4.
So we are at 17 plus 4 for his strength is 21 points of damage.
Woohoo!
which
yes.
Is
that murder wraith hadn't fed in a long time. He's
which
hungry.
Is not quite enough to take him completely out, but it will shake him and definitely occupy his attention. He's like kind of like, you know, murder wraith version of what the hell, Bob?
Just to shake him?
Oh. Yeah, 21. His toughness is 19.
So. Oh wow! Yeah, okay.
Yeah, so
that's right.
They're really tough. So, all right. So that being the case, that murder wraith has gone and done horrible things at your command, and we move on to Seven of Spades, Cactus Jack.
I'm gonna go and hold.
All right. So I will pull out our little hold markers and put you on hold with that. So let me go and get your card. That way I can have somebody shuffling the deck right now. Which brings us to Marcus.
I don't want to draw another weapon. That seems pointless right now. So I'm going to move up my movement rate to the skeleton and just punch him twice with frenzy.
Okay. Go for it, man.
I don't want to put my minigun down, so...
Well, you combat subword is automatically armed and dangerous, so... You're going against a parry of 6.
Parry of 6. I do standard D10 bonuses, as far as I know.
It's just rolling to hit, man.
Yep. So I... what the heck.
Well, frenzy's at a minus 2 as well.
Right, so that's what I'm doing. What the heck? I'm going to extra effort.
You're going to extra effort the frenzy attack. So the sidebar doesn't even bother drawing a weapon out. He just looks up and punches the skeleton.
So and 13 and 8.
8 hits, 13 hits with a raise.
Actually, plus 2.
So 13 and 10, sorry.
13, well, still, hit with the raise. Hit. No, 10 hits, they both hit with the raises.
Excellent.
I'm done. Forget it. I'm pretty sure I know what kind of damage
you do. Yeah, he's already shaken, so, yeah.
You walk up and shatter the skeleton, basically, and that was 1, 2, 3, 4.
My man.
That was 5 movement. Where do you want to go from there?
I have a pace of 8, so 3 more towards the end of the hallway to find out exactly what's down there, since... Everybody else is going this way.
And that puts you at the crossroads for both. All right, card in please, sir. And we got the raspberry wine bat and cleanup before we go to a more complete round.
Awesome.
Well, depending on when you go on hold, or coming off hold. So raspberry wine card in, and what do you want to do?
Well, so I have my armor going.
Yep.
And I can fly.
As a matter of fact, you can.
I can or can't?
You can. Yes, yeah, the reason he set up here is because of this ley line. So, yeah, you've totally got it going on.
So I want to fly over to this weakened wraith. Can I go that far?
What's your flight movement?
How do I know?
If you look at where it says you can fly, it should give you...
1,000 feet times your normal times pace. Two pace.
So
pace is 6.
So 12.
You can go 12. And which way did you want to go?
Towards Wounded Wraith.
Right, that way. So you're going 12 down the hallway. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Now you can also...
The party's this way.
You can also... You can also run, so you can do a D6 and move further. That's an action in case you want to do something else like blast that skeleton or something.
So how many actions do you get?
You get as many as you want, but each additional action you declare is a cumulative minus 2. So if it's 2 actions around, any rolls you make are at minus 2. If it's 3 actions around, it's minus 4. 4 actions, minus 6, and so on.
Okay, well, I want to run and take out the skeleton.
Okay, so roll a d6 to represent your run.
Okay.
5. So 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you go there, and as you're floating past, you're going to do something to the skeleton. So... Which spell do you want to use against the skeleton? Again, there's almost no
burst.
Reason for you not to do your...
Mega damage burst.
Oh!
What, just because?
What?
Get that skeleton.
That's like using a chainsaw to cut a wedding cake.
Right, so,
I haven't
so
used it yet.
Burst okay. is that.
I got a greater...
Burst is the teardrop template.
Yeah, burst is great for like multiple targets or you know things like that.
Yeah, you're only hitting one target. You might as well just like do one.
Do your onslaught bolt.
Oh, I can
raspberry
do my
wine. You do you.
Just do one.
You want to throw a whole party for one? That's
now. Do remember.
Two points, 3d6.
Yeah, but remember.
But I've got 40.
She, when she's done, she's going to be able to do a free draw of energy. So.
Yeah.
Yeah. So she spends the full 4 points. Does the 6d6 onslaught blast?
6d6 is fun.
Alright, so you gotta roll to hit first. You gotta roll to hit first.
It's a casting roll.
You're rolling your casting roll to hit.
Magical.
Now, you're minus 2 for multiple action penalty.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You're minus 1 because you're currently maintaining a spell, so you're minus 3.
Minus 3. So I need wounded? What to hit?
No, she's not wounded. Okay. She got healed.
Top
yeah.
6.
God, she keeps dropping these highest.
I love those dice.
Man, that's
she is.
Yep, 9 on both. So,
so that's
six.
A hit. That's still a hit. So roll your 6 dice damage.
Yay!
Not 7 this time, unfortunately.
Nope, that would have been a red face.
Huh?
He doesn't get a dex roll.
He wasn't on hold. No. The only two skeletons that were
this
active, everybody else basically was on surprise round.
So
8, 10, 14.
Now, you guys
15,
did a good 18. Thing coming in like this. 18. Totally
18.
18,
18 is more than enough to shatter him into little pieces. All right.
Got him.
So, boom!
Great now, kid. Don't get cocky.
Jacqueline, are you going to hold it to the next round?
I'm going to go. I'm going to. I have a pace of 8.
All
right. That should probably put me up right behind Mentok. Okay, I'm actually going to run, and I'm grabbing Mentok.
Okay.
With my big arm, and we're going to move forward as far forward as we can get, probably right there behind Marcus, and then I'll put Mentok down in front of
you. Okay, so you put Mentok down in front of you. Okay.
Aww.
So you gave him the benefit. You gave him the benefit of your rundown.
I did.
I'm okay with that. All right.
And I'm like, yikes.
So are you doing anything else?
No, that was my actions.
All right, very good. Who has least bennies right now? I'm seeing 3 over there.
I have a bunch.
Anybody got less than 3?
Five.
No.
All right, so you get to shuffle, and the Clint Black roll. Yes, Clint, it is your official roll. The Clint Black roll. Whoever shuffles gets a bonus penny. All right.
I use that one, too.
Going this way now. Mentok. 4 club. Sorry, brother. Raspberry Wine gets the
Joker.
Arturo, 9 of diamonds. Twitch, King of Hearts. Cactus, 10 of spades. Marcus, not 5 of diamonds. Not 2 of clubs. Not 4 of diamonds. Ace of clubs.
I like that trade.
All right. There's a whole bunch more people dealt in this time, especially since, as the audience got to see, Skylar, Ambrosia, get your ass down here and bring your people! That he ran over and hit him an intercom.
So we get to have dancers.
Yeah.
Over the loudspeaker, I'll say, no, we're fine, we're all fine here. How are you?
Everything's okay.
Yeah, small containment breach.
So there's a bunch
thing?
Of Grim Reaper
oh, no.
Joker. Oh, just Joe that. The mercenaries like upstairs get that. Oliver Breckenridge himself gets actually he's level-headed. Isn't he? No. Are you? Why are you not level-headed? Why are you not
Because he's a necromancer.
Yeah, whatever. The Murder Wraiths get a King of Clubs.
Wow.
Ambrosia, she gets that. And what's left of my skeletons, and I'm just going to throw the
Did someone cut
zombies.
That piece?
Huh? Skeletons and zombies. I drew really high for my bad guys.
Yeah.
But first things first, you guys all get a bonus Benny.
Woo!
Joker's Wild.
Joker.
Since I've got a lot of nice.
I just did out of viciousness. That was just me being mean. I'm just not going to cover it. My Joker Spades goes first. However, if they were going to draw one, this was probably the best time because they have distance to cover. They're scattered all around upstairs. So they all have to cover. Yeah, actually, they have to cover that much distance. Ooh, 9 plus 5. They have to only cover 14. So they're all gonna have to run. So they're 14 effectively off. The, you know, off this. And they rolled a 6 plus their 16 is 22. 22 plus 14 is 8. Okay. So there's a whole bunch of. You know, they will, after a run, all start pouring in. These are all juicers. So they are running down the stairs.
I had the party.
I don't see how that's a party.
more like a party killer.
Alright, so the first couple of them that run down, you're the first, most obvious one there, they fire at you and bounce their lasers off of your mega damage capacity armor. So having that up was really a really good idea. So this one will change weapons to his vibro sword and jump on you because that does do mega damage, so he's going to do that. These guys... So those two shot, splash, that one jumped on you, these two jumped down, immediately realize that this is a serious outclass circumstance. this is bad stuff.
Was there a hallway down there?
Oh. What's that light? That looks like a train.
Choo choo.
Choo choo.
And they've already moved their full
they
distance.
They together like...
Let's see. I'm going to give them both a smarts check to see if they think that maybe firing at you is still worthwhile. They know better against either one of those. One of them figures out that, yes, shooting at you would be a good idea. Oh, actually, they had Joker. So they both figure out shooting at you would be a good idea. And this is where you're thinking, why did I not bring up my armor? So they're both gonna shoot you. And that's 2 plus 2 with the Joker bonuses. No, they ran. So they don't. That will miss. That one will hit. All right. So they are firing JA-9 laser rifles. So that is 3d6 plus 1 damage against you. And that is what the hell? You know what? There goes the first of the GM Bennies. The first GM Benny is away.
No regrets.
There you go. You know what?
This is how you play Savage Rules.
I have to give you a Benny for saying
this
that.
Is how you play Savage Rules, right? Here.
Okay, so that is so that's 11. Oh, 17. 19. 20. 20 points of damage. 22 for the Joker. 22 points of damage. AP 2. Now, how this works here is you did not have this going, right? We had that off.
Yeah, that was off.
So that AP 2 drops you down to an 8, and I did 22 over 8, which is...
Am I dead?
20 over 8 is 12. So that's 2 wound, or 3 wound levels. You've just soaked 3, so
wait,
3 wound levels.
When
you need 16 to get 4. So, yeah, it's every 4. So
once
I get to the 12. So you're going to be spending a Benny and rolling that and hoping for as high a roll as you can get.
You currently are at 3 wounds.
You're currently 3 wounds,
so you need to roll a 12 or higher.
You really want to do well on this. So you had to roll one at a time.
Okay, so I roll first.
No, you spend the Benny first. That you have to spend the Benny in order to have the right to soak. Now you're rolling 2d6, two six-siders. The higher one comes up. This is...
I hope I soak.
Weapon, right? You got a new weapon. Ballistic.
All right.
Yeah, you have an energy.
So unfortunately that will only soak one. Now, this is where you cannot extra effort, but you can re-roll. I would recommend maybe one more re-roll.
I'm going to re-roll.
You try to see if you get one of those dice to explode.
Yeah.
You really want to explode. You really want to explode it back.
6.
Roll it up. Roll the 6 up.
2.
So that's 8. That's really, really good. That is 2 of your wound levels gone, leaving you with a single wound level.
Neat.
All right, so unless you want to try again, we're going to put you in one little bit of shape. And I will tell you, unfortunately, that means a concentration check. And you have to roll your spellcasting roll against the damage you took, or you will lose control of the
roll. Oh, sad. He's my friend.
You're about to lose control.
So, I don't know if you want to risk.
I think somebody likes that.
I don't know if you want to try to soak all three wounds with one more roll, or if you just want to stand on that and hope you make it.
He's so excited.
Hold it together, man.
What would be the most magnificent thing to do? The most magnificent thing to do would be to completely glance off all wounds with no armor up. That would be the most magnificent.
It would actually be more magnificent to get your armor up later. But anyway.
Oh, I did mean to ask, and I'm sorry I didn't actually do this earlier. It does. Does ISP ever come back?
Yes.
Okay.
Comes back over time, though. It's like takes a. It's one per hour.
One per hour.
You may have all right. Rapid, you may have rapid recharge or something like that, but it's between scenes, basically, kind of. Thing.
Six.
Roll it again. This might you might
come
get
on,
luckier.
Come on.
Might get luckier. Ah, same result. All right. So, and unfortunately, now I need you to roll a spellcasting roll. That is your D10
psionics,
right? Or your psionics roll in this case. Yeah, you had it. That was right. D10 and D6. You need to get, unfortunately, a 22 here.
Whoa!
Not
wait, is that even...
It is possible.
Oh, right, I get
to pop it.
What was that?
Nope.
All right, so unless you want to spend bennies, which I don't
I
recommend
don't
at this point,
yeah.
The murder wraith you took control of is now out of your control.
So now it's like sitting there going... Oh, dude! Sorry,
my bad.
Exactly.
No,
totally
he's
my
like,
bad.
Wait a minute.
What are you
that's
doing?
Actually,
man?
Really good.
Wow. You are delicious.
So anyway, the problem is, it was a really great move, but these guys run down, and you didn't have your.
I learned something.
Yeah,
it's all good.
He's all right,
it's kind of like a bear.
And it is Raspberry's turn.
Woohoo! All right.
Oh wait, I forgot. He jumped on you with a sword, so he does actually get to attack. He rolls a 6, which against your parry of?
Parry is 5.
So he will hit. And he's using a chain longsword. So she may be in trouble, my friends. This is strength of D10 plus 2D8. And these things are AP2.
She does have 4 mega damage armor up currently.
She had way better than that.
I have this plus 10
10
greater
sorry,
10. Armor.
So her toughness
here,
is up by 10.
Plus 5 over
which
there.
Is good because I just did 16 points of damage and that is AP2.
She's currently 18.
Oh my god.
Just barely.
So that will shake her.
Yes.
So you need to make a smarts check for me to keep
so
your spells
you
going.
Your toughness. And then you add 10 for the mega damage armor.
And then I roll what now?
So since I did cause you a shaken result, because I just got to your toughness, you need to make a smarts check. You're plus 2 because of the Joker. So
I'm rolling a 6?
And a wild die.
And a wild die.
Which is another
d6. Oh, well, then I'm a d6.
Did you say chainsaw longsword or vibro sword?
I said chain longsword.
5.
It's the chain longsword.
3 is the high number. Yeah.
Plus 2 is 5, you're fine.
Yep.
Okay.
See, you only got barely hurt, so it's just a simple smarts check to concentrate to keep your spells going. He got hurt really bad, so that's why he had to make a really massive roll. He took a horrible shot. With a laser weapon. All right. So that ends their turn. It brings your turn. Yes.
Sweet. Okay, so
Hey, remember
can
that?
Can you get at the end of that line and do
that?
Yeah.
I was gonna say, remember that sweet spray template
you got
had?
Now, this is where you'd want to do that.
The
only downside is if you move away from him, he's going to get a free attack against you. But it might be worth it.
That's all right.
We'll say you're still maintaining
I've got a confusion that can attack a bunch of people at once.
So you could do the two multiple spells. So you could confuse him. So
shaken.
That you get shaken and you can move away for free. And then move and blast them. Or you could just... Actually, the confusion is probably the best bet. Because whatever it is, you can get away from... You could just bolt him and then blast them. But honestly, your confusion is probably your best idea.
Okay.
So you could cast 2 spells this round. With the Joker bonus, there's no multiple action penalty.
So greater confusion...
Up to 10 targets.
Up to 10.
Well, you only have to confuse one guy to get away from it.
Yeah, I know. She can confuse all of them.
Well, she's only got 5 targets, so the base confusion would be enough.
Yeah.
And is there a range issue?
Nope. Well, there is a range, but you're well within it.
Okay. And so then I'll, with the confusion, and then I'm also doing the...
Oh, we forgot to do something
else. Greater burst?
Yes.
Which is 3d12 mega damage,
right.
Cone shape.
So first things first, before, at the end of the last round, you should have made a spellcasting check to see how much power you got back. So go ahead and roll that real quick.
Oh, right.
Which, do I roll the 10?
Yeah, whatever. What is the name of your spellcasting skill?
Spellcasting.
Okay, so roll spellcasting, which is your d10. Yes. Roll that. This is from last round.
Whoa, it's on its edge.
Yeah. So roll that again. So you got 2 points back last round. That was last round as a free action.
Right. Okay.
So just it was a little bit of bookkeeping that we didn't handle. So you from what you spent, you got 2 back.
Okay.
All right. Now this round, you want to cast your confusion spell.
Yes.
All right. So again, you only have 5 targets, so there's no point in doing the greater one. She may as well just do the regular one.
Yeah. So you can just do regular confusion, so it'll affect up to 5 targets.
So that will cost you 5.
So yep.
So,
you're going to be constantly adding in subtracting from that number.
So my 45 went down 3 to 42. What?
Remember, you got 2 back.
Oh, yeah.
But you can't go over maximum.
Right, so 45 is the maximum she could have.
And so now I'm going down 2 more. So
oh, she didn't. 40? That's right, she didn't cast a spell last round, so that was completely pointless of me. I apologize. Yep. All right, no man.
Okay. So I'm rolling for confusion.
You're rolling for your confusion, which then they'll have to...
And you've already successfully confused the GM, so.
Oh, the 6.
Yeah.
11.
Right.
So, what is the effect of a raise? I think they make a smart
check. Smarts at minus 4.
Oh, my God. All right, so they're all smarts of D6. All right, I'm going to say that the bright orange one is the guy that's on you. All right.
So, what is this, the same as
well? It's kind of like that. They're making a smart check.
Oh, yeah, they make a.
If they fail, they're
so, they're all smarts minus 4. They're all confused. Every last one of them.
Yay!
They're all starting to argue whether she cast a spell last turn.
What the? Huh? What?
No, she told
me. Now, how many ISP does she have right now?
You're a wise eye. Shut up.
Now I do.
Now you can actually move.
Because he's shaken, he does not get the free attack against you. So you could, in fact, back. Now, for example, you could try to back up there. I'm assuming you want to position yourself so that you can get them on.
Yes.
To the other side and shoot back at him.
That's true, you totally could. Well, no, because I know she
wants
to. She actually kind of wants to get all of them. So maybe there.
That's what I was thinking.
Ah, you're right. You're totally right. She can totally get them that way. All right, there you go.
Okay.
All right, now you want to get a good roll on this one because they all get an opposed agility check, and agility is something they do.
Well, that's been no problem with her thus far, so.
All right, so that's a 9.
Okay.
All right. So, by the way, give me your card since you are taking action. Now you want to extra effort that? Try to get higher?
So that was Joker, right?
Right.
So it's a plus 2?
But minus 2 for multiple action. You cast 2 spells this round.
Right.
So
now what do I do?
So do you want to give me an extra, do you want to spend the die to spend the chip and add a d6 to that result?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
So roll a d6 and add it to that 9.
So you start with a 9 plus this.
2.
So it's an 11. So these guys are all rolling their agilities versus an 11. All right. So.
Is there any penalty because it's being shaken?
No.
Okay.
The Savage Worlds does not get into the whole degraded
defense. So, they're rolling whatever die they have for agility?
They all have an agility d10. So okay. They're all rolling that.
So they can't roll an 11.
Well, they could. They could explode.
Was I doing my greater versus the 3d12 today?
So, the best I got was a 7, and she got an 11. So yeah,
none of them get out of the way.
None of them get out of the way, and you're going to do raise damage to all of them.
Yay!
So that is
3 12 sided,
3 12
and 1 6 sided.
You get an extra d6 damage.
Okay, I'm going to have to borrow
something. Boom! What she needed was what?
What
against these two?
Yeah.
That was an opposed.
So the high's got the 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Yes, that's right. Why it's a raise.
Okay. Tell
them her. Yep. Had any of them gotten an 8 or better, then I would subtract the raise die from.
Oh,
12.
Oh my God.
6.
You exploded 3.
Eric.
That's 30.
You're banned from inviting people to my games ever again.
Can you bless my dice?
31.
Oh, my God.
11, 30,
well, wait, so 30, 31 plus 3 is 74,
so these
45,
5
49.
Grim Reaper juicers come running down. These are juicers, man. 5
plus
juicers.
For Joker.
They come in, blam, 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 blam. 51,
51 with 51. The plus 2 for the Joker.
You shut up. Just get out of my...
I'm just saying.
51. Okay, how much? 51?
51.
Yes. 51, folks.
Is that a new record?
No. I'm a novice.
Is that a newbie record?
That may be a newbie record. She's blessing dice. Oh my God, I have a dice blessing in my table.
Every single one of them. Thank you.
All right, so 51 points of damage. Now these guys are badass juicers. They come running down. They blast him. One jumps on you. You confuse them. They're all standing around for a second. You run around behind them, and then you completely blow them all away.
Love it.
So we need to zoom in on that.
That's going that this was magnificent. This does not promise to last much longer, really. All right.
Leyline Walker.
Now you spent additional PPE on that. Yes. Did you mark that off? For the exalted, or for the greater, whatever.
And now she needs to roll to get her points back.
Four. Right. So then I'm down to 36.
Now you get to roll your free action spell cast.
Your D6 to get points
and
back.
You have the Joker bonus, so that does actually give you a +2 on this. It's a free roll.
D10 and D6.
D6.
Right. This is you throwing out energy and then reaching up into the ley line and pulling it back into yourself.
Oops, 10, 11.
So you get 11 points back.
So you just got 11 points back, or up to 45, whichever's.
Yeah, literate 45.
Now, I will point out there's one small...
Oh, yeah, because that took me to 47, so I top out at 45. Yeah.
There's one small problem here. Both of the now very, very pissed off murderers are very aware of your presence.
But one is injured.
Yeah, slightly. Yeah, but that just makes it more pissed.
Okay.
All right, and that brings us to... That was the end of our Jokers. Now we're at the Ace of Hearts. This is almost. This is really sad. Of course, these guys may not even make
now
it.
I'm still maintaining my armor as.
Which is a good idea. Yes.
Okay.
Who's hitting the ring?
I accidentally bumped. Oh, okay. It,
sorry. All right. So the guards all need to cover 10 to get there, and they're just normal dudes. So they're all going to roll a run die, and they still don't make it. So these guys are still two off the board. So these are all the mercenaries that were upstairs at the rave trying to get down, but they're... You might actually hear, like, from where you are, like, oh, no, no, no. You're hearing more shouting and screaming going on upstairs. All right, that brings us to Ace of Clubs, which is Marcus. Right?
Negative targets. Damn.
No, you could go on hold.
Yeah, well...
Or you could go down and, you know, there may be time to deal with the necromancer, but...
Sure. He's got big robot behind him. You'll be okay. 8 this way.
That puts you just outside.
But do I have line of sight too?
Yes. There's two zombies and a
murder wraith.
Right, do I need to stop and read this now?
Maybe.
While you're
not out loud.
Oh, no, it's the thing that I've been told I can do when we get to the...
Okay, they're thinking announcement of something and theorizing. Okay.
There's a thing I'm going to do when the Kickstarter's over.
Right. Okay.
Shane's actually... There's a hint if people will pay attention to Facebook. Shane's already announced what it is, so if people want to go and try to hunt down what Shane said... to find out what the surprise is. Otherwise, they're just going to have to wait till the end of the Kickstarter and find out. But you now know what it is, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you.
All right. I'm extra efforting.
All right.
Just because, yes.
What is going on?
That's what I do.
Yeah, it's not a physical thing.
So that's another 4. So everything's 8 or above.
All right. Roll damage.
I've got a couple 10. I got 9 and 2 tens. So right.
You're
2 raises and 2 regulars. Regular on the zombies, and 2 raises on the...
Okay. Let's see the regular damage on the zombie first.
Yeah, that one's piff.
Yeah, toughness of 8. I'm assuming you're better than 12.
I got a piff. Piff again.
So both the zombies get blown into shreds.
We're right, I'm probably not going to damage, but I'm going to piss it off.
Well, yeah, actually, it's already shaken, so it doesn't matter. So the
it does take additional...
It can't. It's very disturbing for you because you're watching these flechettes just these railgun rounds just fly through it, and it's just going through. It just doesn't care.
Magical support needed this quarter.
All right. Now that brings me to my King of Spades. I got some spell casting to do over here.
So spades is before hearts?
Yeah, yes it is. It goes reverse alphabetical order. Spades, hearts, diamonds, clubs. So, my dude needs to get his magical protections going. So, first things first.
Well, it's like poker order.
I thought poker was spades, hearts, clubs.
Okay. Never mind. It is reverse alphabetical.
So, first thing is that.
It's really, really close, to, but not quite.
All right. And he'll be... He has this many. He's spending a Benny for extra effort.
What, is this like a theater? We don't get to see what he's doing?
Well, I mean, the audience can see him over there going, wah, 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 and there's like, you know, evil dark runes spreading around, and actually he's sucking energy out from just the room itself, because this room has soaked up so much sacrificial energy. And now it's like a battery that he's drawing upon. So actually, you would even sense that all the way around the way, and you can feel psychic, you know, arcane energy. You know, you actually feel like the leftover essences of people's, you know, murdered souls being pulled back out of the room and being used for power.
Feels like a drag.
I'm gonna hit you now. All right. I'm actually going to spend a Benny to re-roll that, because... Oh, I can't, because I extra efforted. Dang, gummit!
Yep. Weep womp.
Hoist it up on my own petard. I gave it all my pencils. Do we get any more pencils in here?
Here.
Here. I don't need more.
Thank you. All right.
You can't do math anymore.
I can't do
math. All right, so that becomes...
Like my sideboard?
It's chrome.
Oh! Never mind, I didn't need the race.
Sure, you didn't.
Maybe. Alright, now, he's taking the multiplication penalty to do the second action, do a second spell. Crap! Because of the backlash rules, he has to reroll that.
Mark!
He rolled a one on a spellcasting die, which means even if the spell somehow went off, he'd still take a shake at the result. Does not want. I'm in reroll mode now. There's the last of his personal Benny's. Doggone. Okay, well, we're going to go with that. All right, so a couple spells go off in there. Like I said, you sense the tortured psyches of you know, horribly murdered souls being pulled out of the room and into him. You sense just the awfulness of necromantic magic. You know, even, and once again, you've even got this sort of tingling in the back of your neck, Arturo, just this general sense that something horrible has happened. And actually, he's going to move, too, because he doesn't really want to be here. Because this is starting to look not good, but he did not he do much watching for a run. So we are now at the King of Hearts, which is Stitch. Twitch. Which, by the way, somebody, or, I'm sorry, Twitch. There's somebody that's kind of moving into your line of sight.
Yeah, no, I'm
now, are you running? Gonna, are you going to lose it? That's the one question I have for you.
Is it, don't you usually do something?
No, I've already got my deflection up. The question is whether I would try it again, but that was just... I can shoot while I'm losing it. Yes! Let's lose it.
So you lose it, all perceptions start to get a little weird, but yeah.
And run into the room.
Hey, Scott Crossan's here! Yeah. Scott Crossan is part of our Monday Night Savages crew here at Total Escape.
Running just inside the door, stopping and looking there.
Okay.
And... melee gets me two attacks.
What do you want to do, brother?
Well, I don't know if I should throw another grenade or just run up to someone and just start shooting.
I mean, you could
Twitch,
do,
I think you know what the answer is.
You could totally run up to him, shooting at him, and then when you close with him, draw your sword out and start attacking.
Yes, there we go. So yes, go to the big B-mock there.
So you want to go for the necromancer?
Yes.
Okay, so
do I know anything about necromancers? Can I actually hurt one? So I'm like, yeah, whatever, let's go for the necromancer.
Why not find out?
Just go up and slap him like a twitch.
There we go.
So as you're running towards him, did you want to be shooting?
Yes.
Okay. So let's clear up everything that you want to do here. What weapon do you have out right now?
No, I had my pistol out.
Okay.
So I was running up, shooting with the pistol.
Blah, blah, blah. Do you have ambidextrous? Do you fisted?
No.
Okay, I remember if you were a two-gun shooter or not. So you're running up with the pistol. And then what, like just drop the pistol and then, you know,
yes.
Go to your sword. So we could say basically you're carrying your sword in your offhand right now, shooting, and then you drop your gun and move the sword over to this hand. I'm okay with that if that's what
two-handed.
You
two-handed. Drop and then two hands.
Okay. Well, you're really strong. You can do that.
Yeah.
All right. It's still going to be a multiple action. You're shooting.
Yep.
I'm just going to charge the multiple action for the shooting and then the runner up with the hit because it's kind of cool. Normally it would be three actions. It'd be, you know, the shooting, switching weapon, whatever. But,
So the shooting isn't fighting, so I don't have my plus two on that.
Oh, yes, you do, because of Gun Nut.
Okay.
Gun Nut lets you get the losing it plus two for that.
Oh, so there you go. So I have no multi.
That is correct. You have no multiple action penalty.
I'm just doing a straight. I'm doing a straight shooting D8 D6.
Blam blam blam.
All right.
Now, I forget, does this thing have semi-automatic or anything like that in the notes for the pistol?
Semi-auto, yes.
So you could double tap if you wanted.
Okay.
That gives you plus one to hit damage.
All right, well, then that gives me a six.
All right, so six minus the four deflection he cast upon himself.
Oh!
As evil spirits are floating around him. They're like trying to eat the laser blast away.
Well, plus it was plus two shooting, but minus two for the multi.
Oh, got it.
All right. So can I add? Is that what I do?
Yeah, roll it out.
Yep.
Although, don't.
No.
You're gonna hit. You really like bam and piff 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 piff.
Okay.
Because this, as it hits, there's like this ghostly skeletal cage also around him, and the lasers just.
As if it was mega damage, and your weapons are not.
Right. So in other words,
that's what he's saying. Don't reroll.
He's got the MDC. However, the other thing you're about to do, the chain greatsword on the other hand.
Yes.
So as you realize that, you come in like, okay, now I'm going to come at him. So
is the D10.
Right.
Plus, oh no, it's just a D10.
And then you roll a D6 as you're all done.
Come on. I need some raspberry love.
Oh, five.
All right.
Fortunately, you got two, mental
seven.
Love.
Seven.
So what's the plus
minus two for multi-action?
So five. So unfortunately, that will not hit. You're not as far off as you think.
Now you should spend.
Either the extra effort or reroll. And I'll go and tell you right now. His parry's a five. And he's minus four to be hit. So you're four away.
You need a nine.
That's a 50-50 roll. It's a 50-50 chance on a D6 or you reroll.
Yeah, let's reroll.
All right.
Yep, and you can actually spend additional to reroll again if you...
Right, yeah. Reroll can happen as many times as you want. Extra effort can only happen once.
Jesus.
Five.
Keep going.
Yeah.
This is one of the main bad guys, so... Yeah. If you're going to spend them, now would be a good time to spend them.
Nope. Go again?
No, you guys, this is where you can spend your... This is where you can spend your blue chips as well, guys.
I totally think that Twitch running up to the...
So you can go ahead and give it to me, and I'll give him a Benny anyway.
Yep.
So give him that Benny back.
10.
10 minus 4 is a 6, and a 6 will hit.
Yay!
All right. So he gets that Benny back because...
Thank you. So then my damage is my strength, which is a D10.
Right. And what's the...
Plus 2D10.
Plus 2D10? Oh my god. I forgot how nasty he's saying. So you're rolling 3D10. And this is mega damage.
And it is the power of the insane.
And, yeah, it is the power of the insane. What is the... we kept forgetting. You're going to get plus 2 on this because...
Losing it.
Yeah. By the way,
that was a one.
That was a one?
The double O's is a 10 on that die.
Yep.
Oh, all right, so it was a one.
You're at 15, 17.
So that's 17. Is that plus... So 17 is with the crazy bonus?
17.
All right, well...
That was as good as we thought.
AP 2.
You can spend Benny's to reroll.
You can't
that.
Spend Benny's to reroll.
Yeah, reroll. That sounds fine.
All right.
Why not?
All right, here we go. If you roll
19. Blackjack.
Yep, 21.
And once again, people can spend blue chips if they want to do it. I'll tell you right now, 21 will shake this guy. And he's rolling 3d10.
Shaking's not bad.
Yeah, 21 out of 30.
All right, there we go.
That's an average roll on.
All right. I got it, Ross, again. All right, then. So you're again. And again, there's this skeleton, bony cage, this astral cage, and you're like cut through, and he's like gritting his teeth. He will have to make a smarts check to maintain his spells, like I did to her. He succeeds. All right, no problem. All right, so that was Stitch on, I'm sorry, Twitch. I keep seeing the itch. I don't know why. There was another character named Stitch, actually, I ran for recently. Brings us to King of Clubs, which is the Murder Wraith. That Murder Wraith is shaken, so he will make a spirit check. Enough. So he draws his vibro sword and steps up on you. Do you have first strike?
No.
Okay. So he's attacking you. That one over there needs to recover from shaken and does so. And both of them draw their swords and run up to attack you. They are trained to know that when they're dealing with spellcasters, they likely are going to need mega damage weapons. All right. So Murder Wraith, fighting a d12. Improved frenzy, so. This is against you. He has a +1 for gang up bonus, and so he's -4 to hit you right now, right?
-2.
-4 with his bonus.
That's right.
You also have the.
We're 2 minutes from the 1 hour countdown.
I was about to say
I
was actually going to ask. After we can we just wrap up this round and then
to
a small commercial.
When we finish this round, we'll take a break. All right. This is basically the final battle. So, all right. So these are both at -3. So 11 minus 3 is
-4, right?
But I'm +1 for gang up bonus. So 11 minus 3 is 8. What's your parry?
8.
So he will tag you once. So chain longsword. I keep looking at the wrong guy. So strength d12. And he's actually using a vibro sword, which is only a d10, so this isn't as bad as it could be. Still, that was awful. So that is 19, 23 AP4 damage.
So that means
23 over 8.
Yeah.
Somebody math that for me.
23 over what?
8, because you're down 4 from the armor pen.
15, 3 wounds.
So okay, you see a 5 armor?
Yeah.
He penetrated 4 of it.
Okay.
So that number goes down to 8.
Okay.
So that is 3 wounds. So you need to spend bennies to soak.
I ignore wounds.
That's true.
I reject your reality and substitute my own.
While you're losing,
you still want to not die.
You may want to spend at least 1.
All right. And so what am I rolling
spend a benny and then you make a
first spirit. You turn a benny, you gotta toss a benny over time.
Well, no,
and he rolled your vigor.
Yeah, not spirit, he needs vigor. Yeah, d10.
And do I do that also?
Yes. Whoop. You want to re-roll that.
Yeah, you definitely want to re-roll that. Alright.
Now would be a good time to nod on this guy.
I've got it in the wings.
That's 5. 1 wound.
That's 1.
Alright. You want to re-roll?
Probably 2 at least.
He's asking you to re-roll.
He's giving you a Benny to re-roll.
He gave you a Benny to re-roll. He gave you a re-roll.
7. Not quite there.
Is that with his pluses?
He doesn't have any pluses on the track.
Oh, well, actually, losing it does increase his toughness by 2.
Oh!
So,
15,
only 2 13 wounds. Would not have mattered. Still 3 wounds.
Yeah, it still would have been 3 wounds.
Oh, well, never mind. Wah, wah, Satrum.
One more.
7.
7 again.
All right, so.
I need Kitty to roll for me.
So, anyway, that means he soaked. Yeah, I've only soaked in 1 room, right?
Yep.
So, you are at 2 wounds and you are shaken this round. Now, again, as long as you are losing it, you don't suffer any wound penalties. This puts you closer to death anyway, though. All right, which, by the way, I will bring up there is a Blaze of Glory rule, which is if you are incapacitated, instead of going to the incapacitation chart and seeing if you die or not, you can say, nope, I'm going out in the Blaze of Glory. And you get to have a narrative exchange with me about how you die and what you want to accomplish with your death. So if anybody gets that far,
all right,
we'll get there. All right, let's wrap up the round. Got a Queen of Diamonds, which is what's left of my skeletons.
And before we go any further, again, please ask your questions on Twitch. We're going to be going to a short break right after this round is finished up. But then we're coming back and we're going to be talking with designers on the game, we're going to be talking with Sean, we're going to be talking with Ross. So please come back
and ask those questions in chat so I can make sure and pass those on to the people that you want to ask them of. Yeah, we have about 1 hour left, 58 minutes and 30 seconds is the point of this campaign.
All right. So, I'm going to simplify things. He lost enough concentration, he lost control of the skeletons. They're really not much of a threat anyway, they're just sort of scene dressing. So, I'm just not even going to worry about them. Bring us to Ten of Spades, which is Cactus Jacqueline.
Question, maybe I shouldn't be bringing it up, but you had the Wraith attack him, and then Wraith had approached
They didn't attack her.
Oh! There's an honesty Benny for you, because I completely forgot.
Okay.
So, yes.
I mind took the D.
So your parry's a 5, right?
Yes.
All right. Well, that's going to be 3 hits, one of them with raises. So let's see if any of them can do enough damage through your defenses to hurt you.
She's swinging her cape at him as he distracts her.
So that is 10, 13, 17 AP2.
She's currently...
That's a shake.
15 toughness.
All right, is that with the AP2?
Her armor's still up, right?
Yeah, okay. She's got 10 mega damage armor and an 8 toughness. So
18 goes to a 16.
Yeah.
So that will just shake her, as you're correct. Make a smarts check.
Do what?
Make smarts. A smarts check.
Spirit. Is it spellcasting or smarts?
It's smarts.
Okay.
When you're shaken, it's a simple smarts check.
Ooh, double critical fail.
Ooh. Cannot reroll.
Bum, bum, bum.
All those spells.
I was going to say, it's bound to happen
sooner.
Now, this all happens at the same time, so your armor still applies to these hits. But after this, all of your magic pours out of you, and you're going to have to recast.
Okay.
All right, so this is the one that was still against your armor, and that won't affect you. And this one, that is 15. That is 19. That is going to be, that's going to end up, you take a shaken result again, which becomes a wound. You'll
and then a wound on top of that, right?
For 18.
With AP of
19. So we come to 16. Not quite.
Okay.
So you need to give me a Benny.
Give him a Benny.
So just slide it to soak, and you need to make a 4 better on your vigor,
which is a D6.
So
you get to roll. You always roll a wild die.
Yeah. All your traits, you always get a wild die,
except for damage. Three. You want to re-roll that.
You want to spend a Benny re-roll.
Oh, wait, she had a joker this round.
No, she didn't.
Wait. Yeah, I did. Yeah,
she did.
She
plus 2
is good.
Five, so
she would have made it. All right, so that means you're no longer shaken. So you managed to hold on and concentrate, you're okay, but you lost all your spells. So you're standing there in front of these murder race, and all your magic's gone. So there's that. That is something to be concerned about for next round. Now it is Cactus Jacqueline.
I'm going
to
go and hold.
Ben?
No, there's a party down here.
Yeah, I can't get there.
Well, with some difficulty. But.
Yeah.
All right, Arturo.
Popping speed.
We're finishing the round up.
Popping speed, popping smite, popping deflection, and then sprinting down the hall towards the necromancer.
Okay.
That gives me double my pace, so I need 16.
Okay. Well, you need to make all those rolls.
I'm working on it. Okay, so...
Yes, under these rules, the Cyber Knight gets a serious advantage with all those free actions.
Speed, I failed. I'll burn a Benny to reroll.
I'm going
to
throw this out there. Raspberry, would it be safe to say you maybe overcome said help? I'm in serious trouble.
Yes, I could use help.
Because that might give the Cyber Knight an indication of where to go.
Yeah. Yep, I'm going to head that direction. Rerolling for speed. I rolled the exact same thing, so... There we go. Know. 9. Got the speed.
Got it with a raise.
So, run as a free action, so cool. Now. Popping smite.
Because there's nothing I can do over there.
Yep, I got smite off without a raise, so plus 2 damage. Deflection. I got off with a raise, so minus 4 to be hit.
Okay.
And now I am sprinting down the hall, running as a free action.
Yep, you're there.
Yeah. Oh, got it. Okay. And I'm going to tell you to get back. And
are you going to do the two sword thing this time? Or?
Yeah. Pop, pop. So two lightsabers and.
They're totally not lightsabers.
No, they're not.
Card, please. All right. So there you are. Attack.
All righty. First guy.
I'm the same way actually. I like to figure your face the right way. So yeah. Good point.
They did catch me off guard from behind.
Whoa! There you go. And again.
Whoa!
Right, so you're going to hit one with a raise.
With a yeah, 15 for the first guy, 15, 14, 13. Oh, yeah.
It could be better. Oh!
There you go.
8, 7, 6 on the other one, so.
So you're taking 2 off because of their minus 2 to be hit?
No, because of multi action penalty.
You did multi action.
Oh, right, I didn't, so that would be an 8.
Well, they do have uncanny reflexes, so it becomes a minus 2.
Okay, so that becomes a 6.
Did you reroll that?
I did. Oh, Elon, plus 2.
So now it's 8.
You hit both of them. Once for the raise. Let's see some damage.
Alrighty.
Elon, whenever you roll, when you roll, when you spend a Benny, and it's an edge, yes, you get to add 2 to the result. So it makes Benny spending ease better.
And there's 2 of us there.
That won't help.
Gang up bonus,
I thought it was the gang up.
She's well, right.
But there's 2 of them as well.
Yeah, gang up bonus still applies.
Okay, never mind.
They get the gang up bonus, you get the gang up bonus. It's a universal.
22 on the one without a raise.
He has a weakness against you.
24.
So you get plus 4 damage from, slaughter one.
Yay!
And the one with the raise.
Oh. That is awful.
I'm going to re-roll that.
9 damage on 4 dice. Much
that's
better.
Much better.
Oh, you exploded so one.
You're at 20 so far.
20.
23.
25. And that's not adding the plus 4 I told you to get, is it?
And the ganging up.
The gang up is for the hit, not for damage. So yeah, you're standing there, you just got attacked, like, oh god, all my spells are gone, and then he just shows up and slaughters both of them. All right, and then
not on my watch.
You,
the magnificent.
She's doing something, but she's not here yet. And then it's your turn.
Wonderful. I'm going to move up to where Marcus is.
Well, first I need you to make a straight spirit check for me at minus 1 because you've got a wound and you're shaking.
What do I need to do?
Spirit check.
Spirit.
So, that's the double turn. Yeah, that one. And that one. And you need a 5 or better in this case because. Yeah, you're fine. All right, so you unshake and are able to act. You're still awaited. So you're going to move it to where Marcus is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, there you go.
And I am going to attempt to mind control the necromancer.
The necromancer? Oh my god.
Well, he is shaking,
you,
isn't
he? You know yeah. I'll tell you right now, you accomplish this, this is over.
The, all right.
If you manage to take control of the necromancer, this is over. You will.
I want to do one thing at the end.
Okay. Well, actually, there is one thing coming that could.
That's what I'm saying. I want to come off hold as soon as he's done. That's right. What I'm saying. This is what I'm saying to you.
Got it.
Okay.
So this is definitely one of those go big or go home. So you're gonna don't worry about spending anything right now. Let's just go straight to the roll as necessary. You're a minus 1. What you roll to hit is what matters here.
Okay.
Your damage roll. So you want to spend all the ISP you can to maximize your bonus.
Oh yeah, absolutely. That's what I was going to. I was going to check and see what my pluses were.
Because he's wounded.
Plus 1 for every 2 you spend.
Okay.
There's a maximum, I believe.
It doesn't say.
You can spend 4 to get plus 2.
Oh, okay. Then I will spend the 4 to get 2.
That'll give you plus 2. You have mentalist too, don't you, as an edge? No, actually, you don't. Okay, but you did.
How much do they minus from?
But you did. All right, so you are going to be at a net plus 1 on this roll.
All right. All right. Is my psionics correct?
Yes, it is your psionics. And you've got no special defenses against this. Either.
What does it do next, Robert? So, what does it hurt up 171 do? I got it. I got this.
Here we go.
I have to change it because
you're
broken self.
Now here's your choice. To extra effort or to reroll.
I can't see what the number
is. I have a 6 and a 2.
See, that is 7 right now.
Reroll.
Reroll?
You basically want to go for explodes here. Now, you get to keep your best roll, so you are at a 7 no matter what.
Okay. Oh, okay, that's
7 is the minimum at this point.
Ooh, he rolls a 10.
There it is.
Roll it up.
There roll it is. Blow it up, blow it up.
Again.
7.
You're 17. At an 18. So my resist is an 18 against
nice.
This.
Nice. Make it happen.
No. This is where all my GM bays come into play. No.
Come on.
Actually,
I have one too many GM bennies. Oh, and that's a spend. No, and there's my last GM Benny, and oh, that rolls up to a no! Damn!
Woo, yes!
So, you reach out and you grab him, and what do you do? What do you tell him?
Oh, wow, I get to tell him something. Yeah. Oh, boy. What would you tell
a necromancer?
Yeah. I release everyone that is under your control.
You said exactly the right thing. I need to know what it was you wanted to do before I describe what happens.
Well, I was going to say to Raspberry and Arturo, y'all might want to get down. And all the mini missile pods open up, and I look at the stairway where I see at the very top, and Ambrosia starting to run down. No kill like overkill, y'all.
and knowing her, I grab Raspberry and leap down the hall.
And you know what? That's just too perfect.
Here's all my bennies.
And mine too.
Yes.
Plus I can fly, so we
all the murder rates are released, and since they were all under his control, they all just dropped dead. Yeah, it's. There you go. Well done. Well done.
Awesome.
That was a beautiful
Hello.
Game.
That was.
There it was.
Right?
Back that was wonderful.
There it was. By the way, that scenario is a variation on one that you're going to see in one of the books called Meet the New Boss. So, yeah. All right. So that will end the scenario. We are up on 46 minutes. You said we want to take a quick break?
Yes, absolutely.